The cancer burden is on the rise in Uganda and Africa at large. This is attributed to both low awareness and lifestyle of the populace. The championing of the fight against cancers in Uganda is not only among her population, but in Africa as well, registering 35,000 new cases of cancer every year, and about 40% of these being cervical cancer cases. In today's episode of Health and Beauty, we seek to understand the milestones, but also gaps in the fight against cancer.
We have got the equipment, which is called state of the art. That's which you can get whether you go to India or Pakistan or the US or the UK. So we've got state of the art.
Dr. Lutu Israel is the Deputy Executive Director of the Uganda Cancer Institute. He warns Ugandans about the type of cancer that highly burdens Uganda.
Yeah, in the female population, the commonest is cervical cancer, followed by breast cancer. In the male population, the commonest is prostate cancer. And then in the pediatric population, it is the leukemias.
According to Lutu, the institute has come a long way and scoring high, now attracting patients from all over Africa.
We can treat 98% of the cancers.
In regard to the recent claim by the Parliamentary Commission about foreigners accessing free cancer treatment services, he says the board is working on setting up a standard procedure for accessing medical services at the facility.
I wouldn't say they are getting better care, because the care we give to a foreigner is the same care we give to our Ugandan people. It's the same, they're the same drugs which kill the same cancer cells. It's the same radiotherapy machine, same doctor, same nurse, same lab. Same pathologist who looks at the tissue for a foreigner and the tissue for a Ugandan. So the care is the same. It's really the same. The other thing why we are getting more of foreigners is we should pat our backs. It's a sign of improved service and trust.
He also speaks on the challenges the institute is facing. Dr. Lutu says the institute is closing the care gap through regional cancer centers and calls upon Ugandans to utilize these centers.
The Uganda Cancer Institute is expanding the oncology, I would call them oncology services, to the regional centers in Gulu, in Mbale, Mbarara, Arua. So those are the four centers we are focusing on.
Dr. Bangida Sisi, a principal radiation therapist, says cancer of late is common in all ages. She cites that prostate cancer, which used to affect men with 60 to 70 years, has now lowered the margin to 40 years. Uganda has one of the highest cancer rates in the world, with gastrointestinal, prostate, breast and cervical cancers, among others, on the rise.
Every cancer has different risk factors and different causes. Cancer of the cervix has different causes, risk factors that predispose someone to have higher chances of catching cervical cancer, HIV. Remember, HIV is now prevalent in Uganda. In most cases today, 10 years down the road, HIV, you might end up with cancer of any type. Okay? So that is one risk factor in almost all cancers. For cervical cancer, having multiple sexual partners is also a high risk. But we also have HPV virus. When you're infected with a HPV virus, yes, we have some cases where cancers have recurred. But these are patients that we have treated. I will say of a specific lady today, we treated her 19 years ago, cancer of the cervix. Came back 3 years ago, cancer of the rectum. All these two cancers are in the pelvic area. But the second cancer is a result of the side effects of radiation.
It has also been noted that nearly one-third of patients diagnosed with cancers are HIV positive. The two groups, hit hardest with cancer in Uganda are children under age 12 and middle-aged adults. In 2020, nearly 20 million cancer patients were diagnosed and nearly 10 million died, accounting for 50%, according to the World Health Organization. Report compiled by John Musenze for the New Vision.
Once one has got a relative who is afflicted with cancer, there could be a chance or a gene in their family tree that they may also be afflicted with cancer at any one time. So we encourage them to come and be screened early for cancer. As we know very well that when cancer is caught early, it can be curable.